to Dwight School Canada's Ridiculously Right Theatre Company's second production. I am so very pleased that you are all here to witness this really ridiculous event. Please, before we begin, I would request that you turn off all cell phones, electronic devices. Yes, you may maintain your pacemakers, but everything else needs to be shut off. There will be a video recording of this play, so if you wish to see it at a later date, come on in, you're all right. We're going to be eating a lot of that for the next couple minutes. So if you would like to see the play later, my hope is to post it on YouTube at some point in the future. Let's see, is there anything else that you should know? There is no intermission, it's quite a short play. So if you need to use the washroom, I suggest you do so right now, in front of everyone. I can't think of anything else that I ought to tell you before we begin. It is my very firm and unshakable belief that one of the greatest things that we can do for another human being is bring them joy. And that is why I love my work, I love working in the theater, and I particularly love working with a wonderful group of young people like the ones you are going to see this evening. If there is... there is no one who excels at bringing me more joy or frustration than these nine young actors you're going to see this evening. Thanks, Cal.
Gotcha.
So, I am going to shuffle through our program for the evening, since we're paper-free, good for the environment. And in the spirit of joy...
Woo!
Yo-ho-ho! Ho.
It's not real!
It's over.
Yes! Record! Lights out. Have you ever suffered from? Can't be prescribed for you.
lung, lung fever, ship fever, or Saturday night fever?
No. No, no.
Okay, are you now, have you ever been, or do you ever plan on being mad, loco, crazy, or otherwise insane?
These are routine questions?
Yes.
Well, no, I'm sound of mind.
Okay. Last question. This strange old man come to Rose in one night, terrified of one-legged man, die upon Fred of receiving a message from a blind man, and give you a treasure map?
Oddly specific?
You'd be surprised how many of us know it that way.
Well, no, that didn't happen.
Oh. So are you telling me that you are perfectly healthy, you don't drink, you are not the least bit crazy, and you don't have a treasure map?
Yes.
Then why do you want to become a pirate? Because I've got to say, those are basically the prerequisites.
I long to live a life of high adventure, to see a world that I can only read about in books, to witness strange new places and peoples, and escape the life of idle luxury that I have suffered since birth. Throw myself to the mercy of the wind and the sea, escape the marriage and life that had been arranged for me without my consent. A pirate's life is bold and free. Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's life.
So that's a yes for her.
What?
Old speed order. Just test the 3 tests of piracy and you're hired.
The 3 tests of piracy?
Yeah. The 3 tests that all pirates must pass before one of the brethren. Let's start the test of intelligence. Can you my assistant for this? Porky!
Yeah!
Ah! No!
I got this.
Come on.
Wait, I practiced this. Okay, good. Yeah! All right!
Aye, aye,
what can I do you for?
This here, Bobby D, wants to be our cowboy. Bobby, meet Porky Woman, our bosun and stand-up comedian.
Welcome, Bobby.
Bobby.
I knew that. Let's get started. To become one of the brethren, you'll have to pass 3 tests. First, the test of intelligence.
Oh, don't look so nervous, lad.
Most pirates only pass one of the tests, and they get along just fine. Now, I'm going to ask you 3 questions. Answer one of them correctly, and you'll pass. Savvy?
I love this part!
All right, let me have your questions.
Okay. Do you see this chart?
Behind me? Or right next to me?
Did anyone teach you guys the alphabet, you know? A, B, C?
Anyways,
I want you to circle a pirate's favorite letter.
A pirate's favorite letter? Letter?
That's right.
Here, catch!
Somebody fix that.
It's okay.
What happened? Come on. Yeah. You can do this.
The most feathers?
The
in chat for my trade, jingles for rhyming, and this is my blade.
Oh, come on, Jack, give the lad back his sword, and give him a fighting chance.
A fighting chance? What do I have to do?
Take a stance and a swing with that blade, and make sure all your fears bleed, because if I can feel a touch of your steel, then you'll either be giving me that blade.
Did you seriously just tell me that I have to fight you? With a liberator.
Good luck, boy!
Thank you.
It was finally mine, in my grasp. until that old fish, clumsy, idiotic! What did I say about that kind of language?
That is unimaginable.
Plebeian?
Oh, that's a good one. That pedestrian. Plebeian? Talentless kept the hangover. Everybody's been derisively.
Mutiny. Stop my ship. And a very special one for you.
What do they steal, Captain?
The most powerful plasma of the seven seas. Second only power to Davy Jones locker combination. The toe ring of Apocalypso!
Dun dun dun.
A toe ring? Are you sure you didn't just lose it somewhere? They're like not even this big.
This is the toe ring of a 20-foot tall ocean goddess, or 6 meters for inventories. It is the size of a salad plate. You know, a little bit bigger than a dinner plate, but not as big as a dessert plate.
More importantly, it's covered by a single ruby, and it's weight 12 times in gold doubloons, and if you account for inflation, of course, and it's magical.
And the most important thing, please pay attention on there, this is really important plot stuff we're talking. The most important thing is that the person who returns the toe ring to the goddess will be granted their greatest wish.
If they survive the journey to get to her, for which they need a ship, which they don't have, and a crew, which they don't have here. Because someone was too busy watching their stories come from keeping them from ruining us.
It was that mid-season finale of Orange is the New Black. How could you expect you to miss, how could you expect me to miss that?
So basically, your two pirates got their ship and their treasure stolen and don't even have a plan of getting it back. I should have signed up for that Pilates program down by the docks.
Don't have a plan? Who says I don't have a plan? I am Captain Mir Fasse, the most cunning pirate in the seven seas. And I have a very good plan. This court!
Yes, Captain!
What's my plan?
He says, rocks!
Ha-ha! You see, young Joseph, my plan is so cunning that it is a surprise, even to myself. And you will be the key that gets us back our ship. Because you're the new character, we need to do something with you before we reveal why you're
I'm not sure I like the sound of this Captain Mir.
It's very Fasse!
If we are going to do the surprise plan, we are going to need a lot of supplies. Not being sorry. Never mind, I'll get my kit measures.
Hey, you two, I'm in person, not a plot device.
This is not true. You, my lad, are neither. You are a pirate, and you're going to steal a ship now. Onwards!
I should have paid more attention during English class. I could be doing Romeo and Juliet right now instead of this stupid pirate stuff. Oh well, yo ho ho.
Leave me on a desert island to die!
Who said anything about that? Just
tour guides. Jack!
I heard nothing, Captain dear, because there's nothing here.
Fight! That's right. Because there's no one here but us. Me, Inky, Lucky, and Jack.
And that mermaid over there with the red blinking light.
And mermaid... Wait a minute, what? Mermaid! Ah!
Lucky, you don't know that mermaid. You can't slander her like that.
Inky, oh, means over there.
Oh.
A mermaid, do you think you see? I suspect that it's a he.
Maggie, put the sink over.
Hi, Captain.
Ahoy the ship!
Ahoy yourself! What manner of sea creature are you and what is your business?
Ahoy, Captain, in saying this. I'm a siren, see?
Oh, Lurky, what's going on?
I told you to keep quiet.
I'm sorry, Captain, but as I recall, sirens don't look like that at all.
Well, if that's not a siren,
then what is it?
It looks like a boy in a mermaid suit. Blinking red light.
It sounds like a trap to me.
Stay your business. Oh, siren!
This is so stupid. I'm on my way to the octopus ball. I am hitchhiking. Sea hiking? I don't know.
So, what can you do for us in exchange?
I can show you the way to the island of Apocalypso.
The island of Apocalypso?
Yes! Recoil!
Fly down the wall. Come out. Let's pull the siren out.
Hi, Captain, but before we do, watch it. This is a trap.
Aye, Captain, you're right. Or Malarkey's right. Shouldn't we have as many swabs on deck as possible?
Like me.
And as for that cabin boy, he's off with Bubby. We have his main buddy. You're not for sure if he had to save us back in the docks.
I don't understand what that means, but it sounds unpleasant.
It is.
So where's that little cabin boy?
The cabin boy you may maroon. I think we should retrieve him soon.
Well, retrieve him. And let's have time to sit.
You got lucky! That was a short run. I once got married for a week!
Wait a minute, where are you going?
House of Cards isn't for just the league. If you want some real lesson in piracy, watch television shows about American politicians. Lay down my articles!
He makes me so mad!
Why is he your captain?
I have no idea why.
You know what I don't have an idea about?
No, but I don't feel like you would tell me.
I have no idea what I'm gonna do now.
I'm gonna better count, Captain. And keep spotting the dead. We'll be at the island by evening.
Aye, aye.
Is he gone?